Hello and welcome back to BIMGeek. In today's video, we are going to check the fire rating values of doors and we're going to compare them with their host wall and check whether if they're equal to each other or not. So let me explain what I mean by that. So I created this simple model in which I have two walls and I think about 2, 8, 16 doors. So some of the doors, their fire rating value is set as 60. And I have some that are set as 90. So I have two types of doors. One is 60 minutes fire rating value and the other one is 90. And I have two walls. The first one is 60 and the other one is 90. And I want to compare the value of the door with the host wall. And if they're not equal to each other, I want to, you know, maybe assign a parameter value or I want to select them. That's what we're going to do in today's tutorial, and we're going to create a simple Grasshopper script. Without further ado, let's get started. So I'm going to start by opening Grasshopper, and this is the script that we are going to create actually. And as you can see, it's not that, you know, it's not that complex. And let me start from scratch actually. So first we are going to reference all the doors in our model, and to do that we are going to use the query categories node. And I'm going to type in the category. In this case, it's going to be the doors. So if I connect this as the name input, I will get the doors category in return. So first, I have to convert this category into a category filter. And then I can connect a query elements node and make a query in Revit's database. Let's do that. So query elements. Let's remove the filter, let's remove the limit and connect this filter as the input. So in return, I will get all the elements that fit this rule, which is the doors category. And if I connect a panel to the elements output, as you can see, I have 16 doors in my model. So let's get their fire rating parameter. And let me show you what fire rating parameter looks like in Revit. So if I select one of the walls and go to its type, it is actually a type property, fire rating, and it has a value in here. In this case, it's 90. So what does this mean is we need to get the element type first. So let's do that. Element type, and the elements will be the element input. In return, I will get the door types. Now I can use the element parameter node to get the fire rating parameter value. Element parameter, the type will be the element input, and the parameter we are looking for will be the fire rating parameter. And in return, I will get the fire rating values of those door types. So these are the door fire rating values. Let's get their host wall first and then let's get its fire rating value as well. So to get the host of the door, we need to use element host node. So this node gives us the host of the given element. In this case, it's going to give us the wall that hosts the given door. So if I connect a panel to the host output, as you can see, I have some walls, generic 60, generic 90, etc. So again, these are elements. We need to get the element type of those hosts. And we're going to do the same thing, actually. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to copy this and paste it again. And I'm going to replace the element with the host. So in return, I will get the fire rating values of my walls. So now is the exciting and important part. We are going to compare the two values with each other. So in here, I have the fire rating value of my walls, and in here, I have the fire rating value of the doors. Let's compare them with each other. And to do that, we are going to use the expression node. And we are, you know, going to create a simple rule. We are going to say the wall equals the door. I'm going to click OK. So what it does is it's going to check whether if the wall is equal to door or not, and in return I will get a boolean, true and false. So let's define our variables. The variable x will be wall, and the variable y will be door. And let's connect our values. So this one contains the fire rating values of walls. It's going to be the wall input. So this one has the fire rating value of doors. It's going to be the door input. So in return, I will get a boolean. False, false, true, false, etc. So the truth means that the door's fire rating value is equal to its host's fire rating value. So I need to filter the falses. So to filter falses, we are going to use the dispatch. So let's connect our list. So in this case, we are filtering through our doors. So I'm going to connect my doors elements as the list input, and the pattern will be the output of my expression. So in return, I will have two lists. The first one will be the truths. So I have eight doors that fits the given rule, and the list B will be the falses. So since we have actually filtered out the doors that doesn't fit, we can do whatever we want with them. So what I'm going to do is I am actually going to select them. So to select elements, we are going to type in select element, and the element input will be the list B, and the selected will be the boolean. So we're going to say select these elements. If I turn this into true, those elements will be selected. So now I know that these doors, their fire rating value is not equal to their wall's fire rating value. So let's check whether it's correct or not. So this one was selected. If I select it, I know that its fire rating value is 60. If I go to its edit type, 60, the same. And if I select the wall, I know that this wall's fire rating is 90. So I know that this is actually working. So other than selecting, we can do whatever we want. As I said, we can actually delete those doors. So if I type in delete elements and connect, let me just make this a bit smaller so we can see the effect. So if I connect list B as the elements input, they will be deleted. Let's do that. Just like that, they are gone. So I'm just going to undo that, and in Revit, I'm going to do Control Z, so they are back. Or we can assign a parameter value to them. So we can filter them and maybe change them in the future. So what I'm going to do is, I think this one was 60 and its wall was 90. Yes, that is the case. So I'm going to select the door, and it has a parameter called comments. So I'm just going to add a comment to this doors. So I'm going to do element parameter. So these are the elements. So for these elements, get the comments parameter. The value will be null, obviously, because right now these doors doesn't have any value in their comments parameter. And I'm going to set that parameter value as fire rating doesn't match. And let's connect this as the value, just like that. So if I select these doors, okay, not that one, this one. So if I select this door, as you can see, its comments parameter equals to fire rating doesn't match. So this one matches, this one doesn't match, etc. So in this tutorial, I checked fire rating values of doors with their host element, and we have, you know, selected them, deleted them, and assigned a parameter value to them. I hope you learned something new in this video. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.